Every time I see the phantom eye, phantom eye, phantom eye, phantom eye, see the phantom eye, phantom eye.
We've been through a lot of madness in this past 1.5 years. I don't know, 2 years. And one of the things I miss the most is recording people live in the studio. It's so cool. Recording bands live in the studio is one of the most amazing, rewarding experiences for a producer. And I'm gonna tell you why. In 1996, a guy arrived at my studio in Tuscany saying, "Hi, we're a group of musicians and we'd love to record at your studio." I said, "Nice, what type of music are you guys doing so I can help better with organizing your session and so forth?" He answered, "I don't know. I don't actually know what we're doing or what we are." And he smiled at me. I immediately liked the project. Also, the guy looked intelligent. And I got more curious than ever. So after we spent a few minutes with him and the others hooking up the instruments, they finally opened up and said, "We improvise music. We would just like to record away everything we play without thinking or worrying too much. And then we would pick the best parts and work on those." Right. And it was fun. And some of it was great material. For the most part of the session, I was just enjoying my headphones. I took some videos in 98 and I thank myself for having done that. What you hear is my monitor and headphone mix in mono coming from the console, just like a live bootleg. On we went for 4 days, and then after the band picked their favorites, we mixed the material hands on the analog console, which means 3-4 people were taking care of a few sliders and knobs. In 96, for the first album, we mixed straight to DAT tape from the Akai Adam 12-track recorder. In 98, an Akai DR4 was slaved to the Tuscans, and I was recording there the mix parts as the song and mix progressed. It was locked in sync with the Adams or the Tuscans that I had later on. No automation, no recall, all recorded live and live mixing. Well, in those years, just like the 70s and 80s, it was still very common to have at least the bulk of a production recorded live with a band. Also for pop and rock music, I had many bands coming over, and all those live recordings, although not perfect, have something magic produced by the chemistry of the people in one room, or anyway, performing live, interacting with each other. In 2012, I recorded Peter Doran and his band at the Grouse Lodge in Ireland, a studio I particularly loved and where I returned several times. Here are some video cuts of that live session, beautifully shot by Kerbute Productions. We did a few vocal overdubs, but this is 90% of what you have on the album, Overhead the Stars. This song is called Knife Thrower's Eye.
Then that you're well aware, what is mine is yours.
This album is beautiful, not only for the songs Peter Doran wrote, but because it's performed by talented Irish musicians, and I can assure you that there is something about playing together that makes every note intensity just different. Well, many of you know all that already, but for the younger folks who love recording new bands that they like, please get them to play and record live. Based on all those many fabulous live studio experiences through the years, I decided to found Recording Festival, a special event at the Grouse Lodge, which you can find out about it if you search a bit on the web. Given the current state of the world, it is in a temporary hiatus, but I hope we'll restructure and restart soon. Here is a fabulous band who participated in 2015. The band is called John Jacob Magistery. Through the album on Spotify, you will hear that the mix of Phantom Eye is slightly different. Of course, it was made by another person. It's a very nice mix, but the production is very polished compared to what you hear in this video. I think this mix, which is straight up from the recording session, best represents the band sound, which is after all what you hear when the band plays live. So, is this a matter of taste? I personally wouldn't mess too much after a great recording session, after all. When you have good material, don't fix it.